Welcome to Commodity Funda. I am Sunil Subramaniam here, Senior Research Analyst from Choice Equity Broking. And today the commodity which I'll be talking about is on turmeric. And turmeric, as we all know, is haldi in Hindi language. And it is one of the very good commodities that is traded among the spices complex. Turmeric as a commodity is majorly grown during the Kharif season, ranging from June to August period. And the usual harvesting begins during the period of Jan to March. Looking at the current scenario, the turmeric prices is actually trading on the bullish zone, basically due to there has been a huge rise in export demand from India. Overall, if you look at the scenario from last year to this year, the exports of India, which has been sluggish during the period of April and May months of 2020, has shown a huge amount of recovery in the last couple of months. Before I begin with the export scenario, I would like to give you some highlights regarding what is the production scenario of turmeric in India. The production of turmeric in India and which are the major states that are being covered in India, which actually grows turmeric all over India. Now, coming to the top 5 states, among the India's turmeric scenario, the top 5 states are majorly Telangana, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh and Maharashtra. These are the top 5 states which actually produce turmeric in India. And looking at the current scenario, the production in the last 5 years has majorly, I'll just move this side, and production in the last 5 years has majorly been steady. But then, if you look at the current year's scenario, the production in the year 2020-21, we have estimated that the production in Telangana state is expected to decline to some extent. Now you would be thinking that if the monsoon during the year 2020 was very good, why is the production scenario in these states, that is the Telangana, Karnataka, and which happens to be in the southern parts of India, to be relatively lower than the previous year? Now, one of the critical factors is that these states in the southern peninsula actually witness rainfall even during the winter season, that is during the period of November to February. So during this season, the crop also witnessed some amount of more rainfall during the growth period. The growth period of turmeric is majorly during the time of October to December, before the harvesting actually begins from February month onwards. So during this time, the turmeric crop also receives some amount of rainfall. If you look at the crop at the physical market level, the turmeric can sustain some amount of water content in the soil before the harvesting. But then, in the current year scenario, we are estimating that the top states of the southern states in India to witness some amount of like approx 5-7% decline from 312,000 tonnes, which is around the production numbers, to around 3 lakh tonnes. Around 12-15,000 tonnes decline in production is expected in Telangana state. If you look at Karnataka state will also witness a decline of 5,000 tonnes. And coming down to Tamil Nadu and Andhra Pradesh, which is also expected to witness some amount of decline in compared to the previous year. This is mainly due to the crop damage that has been witnessed in some of the states due to the physical traders. And that is one of the key reasons why we are expecting a lower production this year as compared to the previous year. Excess rainfall is also another factor why it also even disturbs the yield in these states. So the yield per hectare per kg is also expected to decline this year compared to the previous year. So these are one of the critical reasons why the production scenario of turmeric is expected to be slightly lower as compared to the previous year. Except for the state of Maharashtra, which happens to be in the central state of India, this state has not witnessed any major rainfall during the time of October to December period. So that is one of the reasons why the production numbers has not shown a decline. That is why you would be surprised why the production number has shown a small incline from 40,000 to 2,000 tonnes. So this is the critical reason why. And coming to Maharashtra, Maharashtra regions witnessed production in the major regions of Nanded, Hingoli, Barmar, which is very closer to the regions of Telangana, where in Telangana regions, the turmeric production is witnessed in Hyderabad and Nizamabad regions. So these are the core belts of turmeric production regions in Maharashtra as well as Telangana region. And they have the highest yield as compared to other states. So coming at this scenario, the overall production in turmeric is expected to show some amount of decline, that is approximately 5-10% compared to the previous year, which is another critical factor why the NCDEX turmeric futures is expected to rise in the coming weeks. Looking at the demand scenario, now we spoke earlier about the export scenario. The domestic market scenario is also expected to show an incline as the Indian markets has finally started to show huge amount of opening after the COVID-19 situation has started to normalize. Moreover, recent developments of vaccine is also another critical factor why there has been huge amount of auctions in the APMC markets of Telangana, Maharashtra, Karnataka and Andhra Pradesh regions. So these are the critical positive factors why even the domestic demand is also expected to show an incline. Turmeric, as you all know in Hindi, is haldi. Haldi hamare shadiyon mein bhi istemal ki jati hai. And khaskar abhi ye jo time hai hamare yahan pe India mein November to February mein khaskar shadiyon ka season hota hai. Aur logon ne kaafi acha mauka istemal kiya hai ki lockdown mein kam logon ko bula ke kai logon ne kai shadiyan ki. To is scenario mein bhi हल्दी का भी काफी अच्छा डिमांड रहा है इंडिया में, क्योंकि जो हल्दी है जो शादियों में भी काफी इस्तेमाल हो किया जाता है, तो इस वजह से काफी अच्छा डिमांड रहा है डोमेस्टिक मार्केट्स में, जिसके वजह से मार्केट में अच्छा तेजी देखने को मिला था। और आखिर में जब मैं बात करना चाहता हूँ वो है एक्सपोर्ट सिनेरियो। द एक्सपोर्ट सिनेरियो की बात करें, ये मैंने कुछ पिछले 8 महीनों का मैंने एक्सपोर्ट सिनेरियो उठाया है। Coming back to English, I have taken a export scenario of the last 8 months from ranging from April to November month. And the data, if you look at the data, in the month of April 2020, exports has actually shown a decline from the previous year, that is from 2019-2020. This was the time of the peak lockdown period. And the exports at that time was around 6,257 tonnes, which was one of the lowest even in the last couple of 3 to 5 years. And moving ahead, in the month of July, when markets started to slowly open up, there was a huge demand, while almost around 30,000 tonnes of exports from India. One of the critical factors is that post the July season, August, September and October months are majorly the season of the festive season in India. So there was a huge demand of exports during this period, during the previous year as compared to the previous year. So that is one of the critical factors why the export scenario in the last couple of months and during the last year has been relatively higher compared to the previous year. So this is one of the critical factors that we are also expecting, that since we covered till November, we are expecting that the export scenario during the month of December, Jan and Feb to also show a significant incline compared to the previous year by approximately 15-20% compared to the previous year. So this is one of the critical factors why I am bullish on NCDEX turmeric futures for the coming weeks ahead. Now coming to the outlook part. Now outlook, aap chahoge ki aap kis levels pe aap khareedari karne ka mauka acha hai markets mein, ki current levels pe khareed sakte ya thoda dip mein khareedna better rahega. Main aapko ek cheez batana chahta hu ki aap kahan pe khareed sakte ho. बात अगर आउटलुक की करें तो जैसे मैंने पहले भी कहा था, हम NCDEX टर्मेरिक अप्रैल फ्यूचर जो अभी करंट कॉन्ट्रैक्ट चल रहा है वो काफी तेजी के आसपास है। करंट प्राइस चल रहा है 6,500 के आसपास चल रहा है। मेरा रिकमेंडेशन ये होगा कि आप 6,450 के लेवल पे आप खरीदारी करके चल सकते हो। अगर आप स्टॉप लॉस मेंटेन करना चाहते हो तो 6,000 लेवल पे आप स्टॉप लॉस मेंटेन कर लीजिए, और आप अगर आप टारगेट रखना चाहते हो तो 7,250 तक का आप टारगेट रख सकते हो। मैं अगर इंग्लिश में बात करूं तो वन के आई वुड रेकमेंड बाइंग अराउंड 6,450 लेवल्स, कीपिंग द स्टॉप लॉस एट 6,000 एंड अपसाइड टारगेट ऑफ 7,250 लेवल्स। आई लाइक टू गिव वन की फैक्टर अबाउट द टारगेट लेवल्स। इफ द टारगेट लेवल्स इज ब्रीच्ड बियॉन्ड दिस लेवल, दैट इज अराउंड 7,250 लेवल्स, एंड इफ इट क्लोजेस अबाउट 7,400 लेवल्स, देन by the end of March month, we can expect that the NCDEX turmeric futures to even go up to 8,000 levels. That is during the holy season. So holy season mein market mein ekdam jabardast tezi dekhne ko mil sakta hai, jahan pe export demand ka bahut market mein khareedari hote hue dekh sakte hain. Aur teesri baat kare to April month mein Ramzan ka season aane wala hai. तो रमजान सीजन का भी काफी अच्छा डिमांड हमें देखने को मिलेगा फरवरी और मार्च मंथ में, जो इंटरनेशनल मार्केट्स में हम देख सकते हैं, खासकर मिडिल ईस्ट कंट्रीज में। सो ओवरऑल अगर हम टर्मरिक की बात करें तो टर्मरिक में तेजी में एक्सपेक्ट कर सकता हूँ. थैंक यू एवरीवन एंड आई विश यू ऑल अ वेरी हैप्पी ट्रेडिंग वीक. एंड अगर आपको कोई भी क्वेरीज हो टर्मरिक लेकर या कोई और दूसरे एग्रीकल्चर कमोडिटीज को लेके, आप कमेंट बॉक्स में कमेंट कीजिए तो हम आपके पास वापस आ सकते हैं. और डू लाइक शेयर सब्सक्राइब आवर चैनल. हैव अ वंडरफुल डे. थैंक यू.